गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ विल कंटिन्यू विथ यस्टरडेज एक्सरसाइज 5.2, दैट इज ज्योमेट्री 5.2 पार्ट 2. नाउ विल बिगिन विथ सम नंबर 8, क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी जी -4,7 इज द सेंट्रॉइड. इट इज गिवन. नाउ सेंट्रॉइड इज गिवन. इफ ए इज गिवन सी -14, -19 एंड बी इज 3,5. Then find the coordinates of C. So first we'll write the given part, that is C. Coordinates of A are given, that is -14, -19, means here x1 is -14 and y1 is -19. Also B is given, 3,5. So x2 is 3 and y2 is 5. Now the centroid is given, that is G, -4, -1, means here x is -4 and y is -7. We have to find the coordinates of point C. So by using centroid formula, we know for x we have x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3, and for y we have y1 plus y2 plus y3 upon 3. So I'll start substituting the values. Now see, x is given, that is -4, and y is -7. So in place of x, I will write -4 is equal to x1 is -14 plus x2 is 3 plus x3 we have to find out, upon 3 remains same. And for y, see, y, the value of y is given -7 is equal to y1 is -19 plus y2 is 5 plus y3 we have to find out upon 3. Now see what we'll do. -4 is multiplied by 3, which is in the denominator, so -4 into 3 will be 12 is equal to, see, -14 plus 3 is -11 plus x cube, and for y, and see, -7 is multiplied by again 3 in the denominator, so -3 into 7 will be -21 is equal to -19 plus 5 is -14 plus y3. Now we'll take like terms. See what we'll do. -12 we'll keep as it is. From right hand side we'll shift -11 to left hand side, plus becomes minus becomes plus is equal to x3. And for y, see, again we are keeping -21 on the left hand side is equal to, we have -14, so I'll shift it to left hand side, becomes +14 equal to y3. So now after simplification, what we get? -12 plus 11 is -1, so x3 is -1. And for y, see, -21 plus 14 will be -7, so y3 is -7. So the point C has coordinates -1, -7. Now we will move on to next sum, that is question number 9. See what is given. A, -6. For x1, h is given. B, 2,3. Both the coordinates are given. And C, again C. C is -6, k. Means here now y3 is k. Are the coordinates of vertex of triangle whose centroid, again C, centroid is given 1,5. Hence you find the value of h and k. So first we'll write similarly the given part, that is C. A is given -6. So x1 is h and y1 is -6. B is given 2,3. So here x2 is 2 and y2 is 3. And C is given -6, k, means x3 is -6 and y3 is k. And also the centroid, that is G, is 1,5, means x1 is 1 and means x is 1 and y, here y will come, y is 5. So by using centroid formula, we know formula is x equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3 and y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 upon 3. So I'll put the value. See, x is given 1 is equal to x1 is h plus x2 is 2 plus x3 is -6, so plus minus becomes -6 upon 3, and y is given 5 is equal to y1 plus y1 is -6 plus y2 is 3 plus k upon 3. So now again similarly we'll do cross multiplication. 1 is multiplied from left hand side by 3 in the denominator, so 1 into 3 becomes 3 is equal to h, remains same, plus 2 minus 6 is -4, and here and 5 3s are 15 is equal to -6 plus 3 is -3, plus k. So now when you change the side, h is equal to 3 plus 4 becomes 7 and k is 15 plus 3 is equals to 18. Now we'll take 10th example, that is find the coordinates of point of trisection of the line segment that is AB, where A is 2,7 and B is minus 4,-8. So first we'll try to draw one diagram. See, we have drawn AB. Here you have to find the coordinates of point of trisection, means dividing into three equal parts. So see, I have taken two points in between P and Q. Now you can see here three equal parts, that is AP equal to PQ equal to QB. So what we'll do, let that is P, the point what we have taken P, x1, y1 and Q, that is x2, y2, divide the segment AB into three parts. So what we get, see, AP is equal to PQ is equal to QB. Let this be my statement number one. So now see what I'll do. Now I have to find the ratio. So what I will do, AP upon PB, I'm finding the ratio of M is to N. So what I'm doing, see, AP upon PB is equal to, now numerator AP remains same. Now in the denominator we have PB. Now see, PB contains the point Q. So that means PQ plus QB, AP upon PB will be PQ plus QB, since the point PQB are collinear. So see what I'm getting now, AP upon PB is equal to AP upon, now what I'm doing, see, in place of PQ plus QB I'm writing AP plus AP. Since why? See, statement number what it states, that AP is equal to PQ is equal to QB, all three are equal. So I'm using the common word, that is AP plus AP. So 1 AP upon AP plus AP is 2 AP. Now AP AP gets cancelled down. So what I get, AP upon PB is 1 upon 2. That means the ratio of AP is to PB is, that is M is to N is 1 is to 2. That means the point P, this point P divides segment in the ratio 1 is to 2. So now we'll write A is, that is 2,7, which was given, that is x1 is 2 and y1 is 7. B is minus 4,-8, that is x2 is minus 4 and y2 is 8. So we got the ratio, that is the ratio of AP is to PB, that is M is to N is 1 is to 2. So by using section formula what we get, see, x is equals to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, and y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n. So I'll start substituting the values. For x, we know, see, x is equal to mx2, m is 1, multiply by x2 is minus 4, plus n is 2, multiplied by x1 is 2 upon m plus n, means 1 plus 2. And for y, m is c1 multiplied by y2 is minus 8, plus n is 2 multiplied by y1 is 7 upon 1 plus 2. So by simplification, see, 1 into minus 4 is minus 4, plus 2 2s are 4 upon 3. And 1 into minus 8 for y, 1 into minus 8 will be minus 8, plus 2 7s are 14 upon 3. So minus 4 plus 4 gets cancelled. So what we get, x is equals to 0 upon 3 means 0, and y equal to minus 8 plus 14 is 6 upon 3 is 2. So I got, that is for P, the coordinate P has coordinate 0,2. Now we'll go for the other part, that is C. The ratio of, now see, if you consider that segment what we had drawn, the ratio of AQ is to QB will be, that is M is to N will be 2 is to 1, because we have 3 equal parts. So first we got 1 is to 2, now it becomes 2 is to 1. So again I am taking, see, A is given 2,7, B is minus 4,-8. So by using section formula, again I will use the section formula, that is MX2 plus NX1 upon M plus N for X, and for Y, MY2 plus NY1 upon M plus N. I will start simply substituting the values. For X, C, 2 into minus 4 plus 1 into 2 upon 1 plus 2, and for Y, 2 into minus 8 plus 1 into 7 upon 1 plus 2. Only the change is, the ratio is 1 is to 2 here. Sorry, 2 is to 1. So what we get, see here, 2 into minus 4 is माइनस एट, प्लस टू वन जा टू अपॉन थ्री, एंड फॉर वाई टू इंटू माइनस एट इज माइनस सिक्सटीन प्लस सेवन अपॉन थ्री. सो फाइनली वॉट वी गेट, एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू माइनस सिक्स अपॉन थ्री दैट इज माइनस टू, एंड फॉर वाई माइनस नाइन अपॉन थ्री दैट इज माइनस थ्री. सो क्यू हैज द कोऑर्डिनेट माइनस टू कॉमा माइनस थ्री. द कोऑर्डिनेट ऑफ ट्राइसेक्शन ऑफ सेगमेंट ए बी आर जीरो कॉमा टू एंड माइनस टू कॉमा माइनस थ्री रिस्पेक्टिवली. नाउ नेक्स्ट सम, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 11. If, what is given? See, if A is minus 14, minus 10, B is 6, minus 2 is given. Find the coordinates of point which divide segment AB in 4 equal parts. Now, to divide it into 4 equal parts. So, what we are drawing the diagram. See, A and B, segment A and B is there. Now, I need 4 equal parts, means I have to take 3 points, that is P, Q, R. So, see what we get, that this point P, Q, R divide the segment into 4 parts, means here we get AP is congruent to PQ, is congruent to QR, is congruent to RB. Let PQR be the point which divide the line segment AB in 4 ratios, 4 equal parts. So AP is equal to PQ, is equal to QR, is equal to RB. So what we get, see what is given, A is given, minus 14 minus 10, which means X1 is minus 14 and Y1 is minus 10. B is 6, minus 2. Here x2 is 6 and y2 is minus 2. Now see, if you see the segment AB, Q is the midpoint of segment AB. Q is the midpoint of segment AB. So let the coordinate of Q be x, y. So here midpoint means we are using, going to use the formula, that is midpoint formula. So x is, we know, x1 plus x2 upon 2, and y is y1 plus y2 upon 2. So I'll start putting up the values. I will substitute the values. X1 is minus 14 plus X2 is 6 upon 2. Minus 14 plus 6 is minus 8 upon 2 is minus 4. And for Y, Y1 plus Y2, Y1 is minus 10 plus, and Y2 is again minus, so plus of minus is minus, minus 2. So minus 10 minus 2 is minus 12 upon 2, which is equal to minus 6. So see, I got the coordinate of Q, that is minus 4 and minus 6. Now see the diagram. I got coordinate for point Q. Now if you consider AQ in the diagram, if you consider AQ, we can see that P is the midpoint of AQ. So again, I will use the midpoint formula. Then see R. R is the midpoint of QB. For that side also, I will use again midpoint formula. So see now what we'll do. We'll consider now P is the midpoint of AQ. So A is given. B is, Q we got now, A is minus 14 minus 10 and Q is minus 4 minus 6, that is X2 and Y2. So let the coordinates of point P be X, Y. So again by midpoint formula we know X is equals to X1 plus X2 upon 2, and for Y, Y1 plus Y2 upon 2, that is X is equal to X1 is minus 14 plus X2 is minus 4, so plus minus becomes minus 4 upon 2. Minus 14 minus 4 is minus 18 upon 2 becomes, after dividing, minus 9. And y is equals to y1 plus y2. Y1 is minus 10 plus y2 is minus 6. So plus minus minus. So minus 10 minus 6 is minus 16 upon 2. That is equal to minus 8. So see, I got now the coordinate of point P as minus 9 comma minus 8. Now we'll go for the last part, that is R. Point R is the midpoint of segment QB. So Q, we had got Q and B was given. So X1, Y1, X2, Y2. So let the coordinate of point R be X, Y. That means again by midpoint formula, so I'll start putting the values. X1 is minus 4 plus X2 is 6 upon 2. Minus 4 plus 6 is 2 upon 2. And Y is minus 6 and Y2 is minus 2. So we get minus 8 upon 2. So finally, after dividing, we get 1 comma minus 4. So the coordinate of point R is 1 comma minus 4. That means the coordinate of point which divides segment AB in 4 parts are minus 4 comma minus 6, 9 comma minus 8, and 1 comma minus 4. Thank you.